You know, my byline, our byline is, as farmers, we know two things. We know that any plant from nature is not illegal. And we know that every human being on this planet is not illegal. And what we're working for is a world without borders, for a world at peace. As long as we have borders, there will never be peace on this planet. We have to work to erase, to tear down every border on this planet, because that's the way it was created, right? It was created without borders. Anyway, come, come. They are very shy.
Everybody, I'm Ilocano. I don't know how to English. Very well, so I speak Ilocano. Thank you, ti kadayo ken kadami met dito, ket suportar na kami met to mga Pilipino nga mulmula et hinat natin. Thank you, Apo. I'm Clarita Santos.
Hello, everyone. Happy Labor Day weekend to everyone. So we hear this is the lemongrass. We call it tanglad. And this is the eggplant.
I have the carabasa, squash in English.
Hi, my name is Maida Lutaf. This is one of our produce that we're planting in season of October. October. And please support us if you have a chance. Thank you.
Well, you need to do more than support us, right? Okay, so who you're looking at are actually your last farmers. Arosi, in the area we're coming from, is the last surviving Filipino farming community in the United States. Isn't that odd? We've been here 100 years. We made our mark, right, in agriculture, and we're down to a single farming community. So you're asking, well, how did that happen? What happened? I grew up in a very prosperous Filipino farming community. At one time, we produced more than 83% of all the winter crop, the crop of winter tomatoes in this country. That's how prolific, that's how prosperous, that's how hard-working Filipino farmers were. So now we're down to one. And you need to support us, not just buying vegetables, but in talking to this government, because it was the USDA, its racist practices and policies, that drove us off, okay? That's what happened to us. And so we want to invite you to come up to Arosi. Take the time. You know, we always talk to the Filipino Worker Center, help us build that bridge between the urban and the rural communities. We need to rebuild that bridge, because that's exactly what the Manila town, the old historic Filipino town was that it was along the route. My uncles, my fathers, coming from the Central Valley, working along the coast, they would go down for the winter crop in Imperial County, and this is where they passed through. You know, so this was actually just a place that they stayed during the winter months and then went back to working in the fields along the west coast or up to Alaska. But that's how all these Manila towns existed. And, you know, it's an example of what happened to us as a colonized people. Every single Filipino town, every single Manila town, from San Francisco to Manila to Fresno, have all been smashed, destroyed, taken off the map. And so I'm sorry, this is not the historic Filipino town, it was down on Temple, okay? That was where we were until they decided they didn't want us there anymore. They pushed the Japanese out and the Chinese out this direction, and they pushed the Filipinos out towards Temple. So now they're giving us this little thing called Historic Filipino Town, but it's not historic, you know. It's kind of a way, I think, to not remember where we really were. And it was along the work route of a lot of Filipino agricultural workers that came up and down and stayed here in the city. So anyway, I'm to wrap up. And so I just want to say again, we're inviting you to AROSI. We are the only Filipino farmers cooperative in the United States, so you're not going to be, it's not going to be hard to find us in AROSI, right? You just turn on Road 130 and you'll see our farm.